I am Mr. Sarvadna Gandhi, working as Assistant Professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering from Walchan Institute of Technology, Solapur. So today we are going to have a discussion on topic named as root locus. At the end of the sessions, students will be able to understand the concept of root locus and rules to construct it. So introduction to root locus. Root locus is a graphical method introduced by W.R. Evans in 1948. It indicates movement of pole in S-plane by changing specific system parameters, those are called as gains, from 0 to infinity. In designing a linear control system, root locus method proves to be quite useful. Graphical methods specify root locus plot clearly, showing the contribution of each open loop pole and zero to the location of closed loop poles. So if we change the value of k, that is called as gain, from zero to plus infinity, it is called as direct root locus that are generally used. And if we vary the value of k, that is called as gain, from minus infinity to zero, it is called as inverse root locus. Thus, we can say that root locus of a closed loop pole obtained when a system gain, that is k, varied from minus infinity to plus infinity is called as root locus. So transfer function and characteristic equations. So as you can see in figure 1, which represents block diagram for closed loop control system, we can see the block k and g dash of s are transfer functions in forward path, whereas h of s is a block with transfer function in backward direction, or we can call it as feedback. And this closed loop system is negative feedback system. So if we try to write the closed loop transfer function for this block, so we can write it as k into g dash of s divided by 1 plus k into g dash of s into h of s. So we can substitute the value of k into g dash of s as g of s. So the equation comes to be g of s divided by 1 plus g of s into h of s. Then if we want to write the characteristic equation, so we can write it as 1 plus g of s into h of s. So if you observe the closed loop transfer function, so whatever is present at the denominator, that represents characteristic equation of closed loop control system. So if we take the roots of this characteristic equation, then those roots are called as closed loop poles. And if we want to take the open loop transfer function for this block, we can write it as g of s into h of s. And if we take the roots of this g of s into h of s, then those are called as open loop poles or open loop zeros. So generalized representation of open loop transfer function can be written as g of s into h of s is equal to k into s plus z0 s plus z1 dot 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 up to s plus zn divided by s plus p0 into s plus p1 dot 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 up to s plus pn. So we can have this as numerator upon denominator. So whatever is present at the numerator, those are called as roots, and whatever is present at the denominator are called as poles. So at the numerator, you can have a polynomial equation, or you can have the simplified version of it. The same case applicable for denominator also, you can have a polynomial equation, or you can have the simplified version of it. So if you see this open loop transfer function carefully, so you can see at the top that represents numerator, so the roots lie at s is equal to minus z, s is equal to minus 1, s is equal to minus 2 up to minus zm. So if we see the denominator part, so we can find that there are poles existing there, and the roots are at s is equal to minus p0, minus p1 up to minus pn. So system stability. So whenever a control system is designed, the inherent capability should be stable. The system should be stable. So for that, stability is the desired property of any design control system. A system is said to be stable if the system eventually comes back to the equilibrium state when the system is subjected to initial conditions. A system is unstable if the output deviates without bound from its equilibrium state, then we said that the system to be unstable. And a system is said to be marginally stable if the system tends to oscillate in its equilibrium state when subjected to initial conditions. So these are some concepts which tell us regarding the system stability, whether it is stable, unstable or marginally stable. But in the control system, we are going to define a system to be stable or unstable depending upon the roots where they lie. So it is advantageous for us to know the movement of closed loop poles in the S-plane, so which is found by using closed loop characteristic equation. So in this slide, we are going to study regarding movable and immovable roots, correct? The roots which are obtained from open loop transfer functions. So those represents open loop poles or open loop zeros, and these roots are called as immovable roots, whereas the roots which are obtained from closed loop characteristic equation, so those roots are called as movable roots, and which are obtained by varying the value of k, correct? So the zeros, whatever we are going to get, are represented by a circle symbol, whereas the pole that we get are represented by cross symbol in S-plane. So what does S-plane means? So in this, we are going to have x and y axis. On x axis, we are going to represent the real part, and on y axis, we are going to represent the imaginary part. So if you consider the example of open loop transfer function, which is given to as g of s into h of s, we have at numerator k into s plus 2 divided by s plus 3. So whatever is present at numerator, that represents zeros, and whatever is present at the denominator, those represent poles. So if we try to plot this on the S plane, we get roots at minus 2 and minus 3. So as you can see on the figure 2, which represents S plane, so it is there on the left hand side, which is shown in green color. So the roots which are lying on the left hand side of the S plane represents that the system is stable. And if the roots are lying on the right hand side of the S plane, then we say that the system is unstable. And if the roots are lying on the imaginary axis, so we have two cases, we can say that the system is marginally stable or system is unstable. So it depends upon the roots. Fine. So now we are going to discuss regarding angle and magnitude condition. For a given closed loop characteristic equation that is represented as 1 plus g of s into h of s equal to 0. So we are going to rearrange the terms. So we can write it as g of s into h of s is equal to minus 1 plus j into 0. So we are writing it in complex form because we are going to represent this in S plane, correct? So for any point to be on S plane, so we need to see whether it lies on root locus. So for that, it needs to satisfy the angle and magnitude condition. So first condition is called as angle condition, where we are going to have angle signs on both the sides, that is on right hand side, on left hand side. So if we try to equate that, then whatever the angle we are going to get should be odd multiple of plus or minus 180. So it can be plus or minus 180, plus or minus 540, or it can be plus or minus 900. So it can be equated to plus or minus 2q plus 1 into 180. So if this angle condition is satisfied, then we can say that the point lies on root locus. If the angle condition is satisfied, then we go for checking of the magnitude condition. So we are going to put mod on both the sides of the equations, and we are going to find what is the value of k marginal from the magnitude condition. So while checking the magnitude and angle condition, we have to note that magnitude condition can only be used when a point lies in S plane is confirmed by the existence of angle condition. So one question for you: what will happen to root and root locus by changing the value of k? These are my references. Thank you.